Today we're taking a look at the Remarkable Type Folio and how it completely changed the way I use my Remarkable Paper Tablet. Hey guys, welcome to another video. So I already talked about the Remarkable Paper Tablet in a few videos back in the day when I first got it and when I started using it, but I recently got the Type Folio, the keyboard that goes with it, and oh my god, it changes everything. So I thought today I'll just share my thoughts on this keyboard. Is it worth the money? It's quite a steep price tag, but does it really provide the value that it sets out to provide, and how it changed my personal workflow for the better? And by for the better, I mean much, much better. Without further ado, let's get straight to it. So this is what my usual setup would look like. So I have my keyboard, the Logi MX keys. I absolutely love this thing. And my MX Master 3, which is really beat up, but still does a pretty good job. And the way I would work is I have my Remarkable notes on one side. So here I have the customer lifetime value analysis. Those are the notes for my article. And I would take those when I'm thinking about it, when I read other material, and then I'll go in, have this on one side, and on the other side, I'll have my article write-out, where I'll just go in and put all those notes together, go up and down across the notes, go up and down across the article, and input little bits here and there, and at the end, I'll use Grammarly to make sure that it's redacted well, there are no grammar errors, etc. And this has been really good for me as a setup. I tried a lot of different apps. People keep recommending writing apps, and I keep coming back to Microsoft Word. I don't know, maybe it's because I'm so used to it over the years, or maybe it's just, I don't know, it's just a good piece of software. But the thing is that maybe if you're looking to write a book, then you need something with like chapters management, character development arcs and stuff like that. But for an article, I'm pretty sure Word can do pretty much anything you need. If I move the keyboard away, and so I don't need the mouse anymore, grab the Type Folio, open it up, and installing it is like really simple. Just slide it in and that's it. And you have a nice, like, gets a bit hefty, but I like the weight to it, especially if I'm like working on a flat surface. You can just go in and have your notes here. And you see here, I have my notes for another article that I'm working on. What I can do now is I can just grab that, and there are little flaps here, so we don't need this anymore. Just raise that, and voila, it's a keyboard. And it snaps into place and auto-rotates to landscape mode. And you see, I immediately got this little typing tool here where you can, you know, have a lot of options. You can pretty much pick titles, subtitles, text, and bullets. And bullets can be indented with the tab key here. But what I really like about this setup is that this is a full-size keyboard. So the keys are full-size, they're really clicky, which is really cool. And now I can just add a new page, and you see here I've already started using that, and this new page can be typed text, and I can reference between the two pretty much the same way I was doing with Word and the Remarkable app. Okay, I cannot see them side by side at this stage, but still it's pretty amazing. So we can just use the arrow keys, and it's gonna activate the typing tool. And it's a bit hard doing it behind the camera, but the typing, it was a bit weird in the beginning. I kept expecting there to be more space on the left next to the AS keys. And that's why I usually type S. I moved those here, so I'll type S instead of A, but the more you type, you get kind of used to it. And the other thing is that what they say on the folio box is typing without distractions, and that's exactly what you get. As soon as you open this and you start focusing on it, maybe have my earphones in, play some music, it's really amazing. It really allows you to focus, and the typing experience is pretty great. Yeah, I'm still struggling a bit. And keep in mind, my arms are stretched because I'm behind the camera, which makes it much harder. But this typing here, as soon as I started typing this, somewhere around like 3/4 in from this piece of text, I almost didn't have to go back and make any corrections. And the other thing is that at the end of the day, I'm gonna pass this through Grammarly as well. So in the beginning, while I'm still doing typos, Grammarly would pretty much catch all of those. And another quick tip, I noticed a lot of people are unhappy because the marker sits here on the top. And it would be much easier to have it on the side, but it can stand on the side. I haven't found a lot of use cases where I would have like the marker and type something next to my text or sketch something, things like that. Maybe I'll have those in like drawing out diagrams or stuff like that in the future. But for now, I haven't had to do that a lot. But I've always loved the fact that this is really highly magnetized. So there are a lot of places you can stick it. What I like to do is I'll just leave it here. It doesn't stick that well as it on its on the place it's supposed to go, but it's still a pretty good way to keep it closer. And there's also another thing. So here you can do like that and just make that flatter, which is much better when you're working on a standing desk or when you have to take a lot of notes while you're typing. As soon as you're done, just slap it back down, it auto-rotates to portrait mode, close it up, and there you have it. And the other great thing about that is that the way this closes, the keyboard is pretty much hidden, so it's covered, there's no dust going in, and I've always hated all those cases where the keyboard would sit here and it would brush against the screen, and over time you get those like marks from the keys. And even in high quality keyboard cases, this always happens because it's still a bendy material, whatever it is, it would still start to like bend with time. And the way they did it here, it adds a bit of bulk. But I gotta say, it's much, much nicer. I'm a Connect user, which is Remarkable's cloud subscription, which I got because I pre-ordered the Remarkable 2 before it was released. So I'm not paying for the cloud subscription, but being a Connect user gave me €50 off. So it was €150. And I gotta say, it's definitely on the steep end, but I use the Remarkable pretty much daily for at least a couple hours a day for work and for writing, for journaling. Pretty much everything that I do professionally uses the Remarkable in one capacity or another. So for me, it totally made sense to make this purchase, and I'm really happy with the product. If you do a lot of typing and you don't need to have like images and stuff like that while you're typing, it's definitely a great accessory for your Remarkable 2. Okay guys, that's all I have for you today. Thank you for watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Also, don't forget to subscribe if you're not already, and maybe even punch the bell icon to receive notifications every time I upload a new video. Till then, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.